come out by itself. Gone are the days where women deliver at home incontinently, and we need to deliver them. So came the era of midwives, and came the era of obstetricians, and now the field of obstetrics is very well developed, that a baby cannot be born without obstetricians attending to labor. And even when obstetricians attend, we can't guarantee that the baby would be born by a natural delivery or a spontaneous vaginal delivery. So use of vacuum extraction relative to forceps has increased in the US, accounting for almost 68% of all operated vaginal deliveries in the year 2000, an increase from 41% in 1990. So serially, the vacuum extractor has been used quite well and has been gaining popularity. But please get the point that forceps is a very old instrument which has been used for centuries more than that. Having said vacuum and forceps as two separate arms of the same body, we need to understand that the indications, contraindications of applying a vacuum or a forceps are almost the same. So let me reiterate the prerequisites for application of a vacuum extractor or a forceps delivery. Cervix has to be fully dilated. Head has to be rotated fully so that the AP diameter of the pelvic outlet is in line with the sagittal suture of the fetus. Bladder should be empty. Bowel should be empty. Operator should be experienced, and an informed consent to be sought. And to choose the instrument between the two, the vacuum or the forceps, is absolutely in the hands of the operator, the obstetrician, and he can decide or she can decide on what the choice or the expertise with which he or she is trained with. And so, though you have merits and demerits of both, the application would be the same. The only difference between the vacuum and the forceps is that if you keep the station of the presenting part assuming vertex, you would apply a vacuum at plus 1 or plus 2 of the plus 3 classification of pelvis. Whereas if it is going to be a forceps, you have two different types of forceps. The low mid cavity forceps, that is the Willi-Murray's axis fraction forceps, which can